are episode number 50. It only feels like yesterday since I sat down for the first time to record some of those truly horrific reviews. Some would say they haven't exactly got much better, and you lot, you might be right. So, thanks to all of you lovely people that continue to tune in just to listen to the ramblings of this old gobshite. Mucho apreciado. But as for today, we're back over stateside with our mighty collab to truly mark the occasion. From New York's finest, with just a little help from some lumberjacks out west, we have Equilibrium and Portland, Oregon's Great Notion Brewing for the third iteration of their Big DIPA, Juice Equals Juice. Poured heavily with Citra and the ID7, and finished with a big Galaxy hop drop, giving the brew a big aroma of pulpy tropical juice, with flavours to follow. A jumbo medley of island fruits, freshly squeezed orange juice, big peachy notes, and a little step over to the dank side. A noticeable but mild bitterness up front, a pillowy mouthfeel, with a smooth, juicy finish, making this extremely balanced and oh so drinkable. Batch number 3 burst with EQ's trademark melon rainbow finish. In a nutshell, juice does indeed equal juice. And I'm sure, as most of you are well aware, EQ do not play around. So it's always a treat to crack into another one. So with the half ton well and truly up, let's get pouring. Oh, and it is real juicy, as you might expect. Huge pineapple notes really kicking things off. Some peachy and passion fruit notes in there as well, and just a subtle note of that dankness that's lying dormant. So yeah, you're hit with a real juicy, sweet, tropical honeydew right up top, and then that citrus bitterness really comes to the fore, with some real grassy and piney notes right in behind. And subtly in behind, that dankness is lurking, aided in part by that 8.5% ABV. And there is just an ever so subtle earthy note in that finish too. And as you'd come to expect from the likes of EQ, it does have a big, full, fluffy, yet smooth mouth to it. There really is a whole lot going on in this, as we're starting to develop some real piney and resinous notes in those middles that are bleeding into the finish too, as well as that dankness and that underripe fruit note really starting to pull hold in the mids, while it still manages to remain just an ever subtle note of that sweet orange smoothie. And that finish, it really does have some bite. That grassy, zesty citrus, that piney resinous note, and that dank note really do hit you hard in the tail. And as well as a subtle earthy note, there is just a subtle note of black tea in there too, and an almost subtle milky or creamy note hidden in there as well. And now we're down into the final third. This has been truly complex and ever developing. Starting off with those huge, juicy and sweet tropical notes right up top, before growing into something just a little darker, as the more bittering notes start to enter the fray. and things finish off with a real West Coast style finish. Grassy, piney, a little touch of straw, and oh so dank. But throughout it all, it still manages to maintain just a delicate hint of those sweeter juices and a real fresh, zesty citrus. And all while it fills the mouth with a creamy, foamy, full-bodied smoothness, only ever broken by that devilish bitter tail. And as far as a full-on pint of 8.5 goes, it sure is pretty easy drinking. All that's left to say is thanks again for getting me to 50, and we won't stop until we get that ton up.